just want someone to save me.
That I graduated from St. Bonaventure's College, which has a quality in itself. And I think the education and academically what you get from a school like this is important and is what's going to affect my future. I think I'll look back at it and say, I got through St. Bonaventure's. I can get through anything now, right?
Gotta follow where I'm leading. Philly. Okay. What we are gonna do is something called the Scream Run. You're gonna go three at a time. What you're gonna do is you're gonna start screaming. You can run down the hill as fast as you can.
Yeah.
Oh my god! I'm not going!
I thought my friend.
St. Bond's has influenced the way I write. A lot of my writings come from religion class. So I don't know, just things that inspire me in classes, from teachers' perspectives, friends that I've met here. But it's also shaped the way that I look at the world, being here at St. Bond. So it has influenced the way that I write and the things I write about. So
we're making candles.
Why?
Because we want to.
For what?
For fun.
What is it gonna mean?
It's gonna mean that we're making candy.
It's called We Like to Kill Time.
That St. Bond's creates a very more tight, close-knit and a smaller area where you get to know everyone because there's less people. I've gotten over that a bit, so I think just by me changing, my life has changed.
Welcome to the Hotel California. Such a lovely place.
Ready.
Ready.
High fives away.
Well, in terms of our class has been pretty, we've all been really close. It's been kind of important to me to have this, we have a really small class size, so it's good to get to know everybody. So it seems like I've gotten to know a lot of the people in our class and in our school a lot better. So it's just one thing that I find is pretty important.
See, Waylon.
I was actually a little bit intimidated at first when I first came here, and then after I got to know everybody, I thought everybody was going to be snobbish at first, but after I got to know everybody, I kind of mellowed out a little bit, because I mean, I found that I actually had people here who didn't know anything, the people here didn't know anything about me, they didn't care because they didn't make any judgments or anything like that. To them I was another person, and I opened up to them, they welcomed me here with open arms. And if it wasn't for them, I probably wouldn't be the person that I am today.
Can't you light up a candle? Can't you show me the way?
teachers are here for a reason, and the students are here for a reason, and because of that, there's a kind of spirit that develops, and camaraderie, and you wouldn't see the links between people that you would see in other schools, and I don't think that's just the size. I mean, I think it has a factor, but I think, yeah, just the bond that people have with each other.
Since this grade 12 was my second year in St. Bonds, everyone is really nice. Not only teachers, but like all the friends and all the guys are nice. And you know, like it's pretty small school. Like everyone knows each other. And like, I never imagined coming this kind of school, but I love it. Yeah.
Let's all run
next door. We're throwing right over. Send Kenneth right over.
Go, Ken.
Go,
Kenny.
Go, Kenny.
Go. Okay, okay.
Graduating from St. Bond's is unique, mostly because of class size. We've only got 12 kids. But aside from class size, it's unique in a sense that that no other school in St. John's has an equivalent of a lounge. Lounge, I think, is the most unique part of graduation because it's sort of like our indoor playground. It's like having a second bedroom, the lounge.
She's in the book, isn't it?
Yeah, it's right there on the sheet bottom off of her.
I've never read the chapter.
Alrighty, look at me. Look at me. 3, 2, 1, hold it. Hold it. Perfect. One more time, okay?
What if someday we could wake our children to a world where no person died of starvation or dehydration, where all could exercise their right to learn and to go to school, do what makes them happy, where all can share the privileges that we do in this part of the world?
But even at a public school, just for example, you have your small group of friends, and then you'll have your acquaintances, so everyone that you know. You kind of say hi to if you see, but you don't really talk to a lot. So here at St. Bond's, like, it's totally different. Like, you get to know everyone so well. I think it's those little insights to everyone's character in the class that, like, it kind of helps me know them a little bit more and stuff like that. So that's really cool, really special, something that's obviously different. I don't know. I guess it's just that connection that we all have that makes it all really different. Not only with the students, but with the teachers, you know.
Be one or two. So we've been through quite a lot together, and it's not just like a regular classroom teacher where you might have them for a year or two. And for students who are in the band program, there's a real family kind of thing when you see these children for 8 years. It's almost as much as your own children.
My name is Helen Walsh, and I am new to the St. Bond's family,
and I'm very, very happy to be working with these wonderful young people.
It's like a family type role. You get to know your students very well. You get to know their characteristics, their personal characteristics. And it's more like a family, so we're such a closely knitted school, and for example, the family groups. You don't see that in many schools. So I would say my role is went from not just a conveyor of information, but as well as a sort of a family, as a leader, sort of like a parent and a family would sort of guide their kids along. My role was more of a guidance role. I would guide them along a certain route and try to get them to make educated decisions and sort of think outside the box.
I think that just being involved in everything that the school has is an experience every day, and just getting to learn the teachers and having such close relationships with everybody. I think we're all recognized for how special we are and everything that we've been involved with, and that's unique because I think in every other school we'll get lost in the shuffle, but here we're just recognized for who we are.
Okay. On your mark. Get set. Go.
Well, you get so attached to everyone. The longer they stay here, the more you share, the closer you are. And every year, teachers, everyone has to prepare themselves to let go. And that's difficult, but of course you want the best for everyone.
I ran into a few teachers a few months ago. Actually, no, I ran into a teacher last year, my grade 5 teacher, and she couldn't believe that I was at St. Bond's. She was here for Heritage Fair last year, and I ran into her. She didn't recognize me at first, but I approached her and I said, you were a teacher at St. Pat's, weren't you? She was like, yes. And I was like, you taught me in grade 5. She goes, oh, what's your name? I was Mark Snook. She goes, oh, Mark. And, you know, she started being right nice and everything, right? And she could not believe that I was in a private school because I was supposed to pretty much amount to nothing, right? And, you know, it's shocking to say, but that's how these teachers, I think, in some of the public, some of the schools out there today think. They're only out for the paycheck. They don't care about the kids, right? So dropout rates are going through the roof, right? Kids are dropping out left, right, and center. And, you know, what are parents going to do, right? And what are, like, you know, teachers like, oh, well, you know, it's their choice. You know, teachers don't care, right? But here, they do, right? And that's what I like about the school so much.
Say half of them are from St. Bond's.
I want to thank, and I'll have opportunity to thank again this evening and at graduation, so you'll hear it over the next few days, but there is one person in particular, known, he has been an incredible support to our school these past 2 years. You know, he's moving forward because that's a part of his training. He wouldn't leave if he didn't have to, but he's under obedience and under orders by the Jesuits, provincial, just like all Jesuits. And he's going to be going to Mun for 6 months working on his master's, and then he's going to be going to Oxford in England, working at the university there, where he will be completing his thesis and his degree. And he has been our chaplain, and he has taught you, and he's done so much for the school. So Mr. Knox XJ.
Some of the things that I would only see at St. Bond's, there'd be three things that I could think of off the top of my head. Students who are so active and necessary for the school to run properly. Students who seek relationships with their teachers and see those relationships as an important part of their lives. And students who have the ability to express their faith with confidence and sincerity. Those are three unique things that I haven't seen in any other place that I've worked.
Hi! I'm going to Pratt's because I'm special!
Yay, Pratt's in
Pratt's!
Yay, Pratt's in Pratt's!
Yay,
Pratt's! Yay, Pratt's!
Yay,
Pratt's!
Yay,
Pratt's! Yay, Pratt's!
How do I feel about my graduation? Thank God! This year has been so long, and has taken forever, and half of it has been ridiculously horrible. I spent the first half of this year using this wonderful computer to do the yearbook until, you know, January, which was horrid. I'm a lot closer to everyone in the class than I would be if I was graduating from somewhere else. Like, you know, it's possible to know 11 other people really, really well and understand, to, at least to some extent, who they are.
Martino, I like yours. You did a good job.
It's long hours, long hours. Some might say I imitate nature very well.
I think at my school there were maybe 150 graduates or something like that. So maybe 20. You know, so I graduated with probably 8 people who knew 20, who then happened to be in the same room with 150. It was that sort of an experience. And it was, like I said, it was entirely mine. When I'm here and now seeing you guys graduate, it seems different in the sense that you're a smaller group. There still may be an experience that's taken or lived, you know, in relation to the grad, but it's yours. And so I'm sort of watching it from a different angle now. So maybe the similarity would be if I try to imagine what I would have been like for other teachers back then, who I would have been like. And that maybe is the only consistency.
One more time. This way.
I will miss the singing. I will miss guitar playing. I will miss the groaning of yet another English assignment. And I will really miss Mark and Stephen's banter. Definitely. The morning banter between Mark and Stephen will definitely be a memory.
Community feel that you get in a school like this is something that's pretty unique as well, because you have the parents being so involved and the guardians being so involved in what's going on in day-to-day school life as well as over the course of the years. So that's something that you won't get in any other school probably. It's a pretty unique situation.
It has, I guess, a lot of the things that a teacher would look for in terms of the relationship amongst teachers, relationship with the students, and just the way the students treat each other and the whole idea, the whole philosophy behind the school. It's such a positive and positive environment that that most people probably won't see in their teaching career. So for me to be able to see that at the beginning of my career, it certainly makes me appreciate where I am.
Traffic in the sky and it doesn't seem to be getting much
better. It also depends on the thickness of the space, too.
Kids playing games on the pavement, drawing waves on the pavement.
This one is
0.6. I can't sing and play at the same time. Because I get distracted.
That don't seem like it'll make you feel better.
So hard to please, but look around, leaves are brown, and the sky is a hazy shade of winter, in the Salvation Army band.
Time to see what's become of me.
refuse to answer, you know, it may incriminate me.
Give each man an idea. You thy voice. Take each man's censure, but preserve thy judgment.
Keenan, very different and fair. Ha ha ha, Keenan.
We love Take One.
Take One! Take it away, Kenny.
Alright.
The execution begins.
Alright. Okay. Please just take one.
Take one.
So I open. Yes. Yes. Good. One piece.
So this is Charlotte. She's my friend, and she saved my for Enterprise.
I'm not recording. Now I'm recording. Go ahead.
Take one.
Yep.
Take one.
Two words, people. Breathe well and never forget.
A little note to the administration. You can't get rid of me that easy. Don't worry, I'll be back to visit.
Miss Mulhay, she's a pretty cool homie teacher. She baked me brownies. You gotta love that, right? You know, a teacher that makes you food. You know, straight, you're in my heart now, right?
Double, double, toil and trouble, fire burn and cauldron bubble.
Ryan took the dragon without dragging it to climb up a wall.
What is your most memorable? What is your most memorable experience that you can't think about?